Hello, it's Jim from Early Birds. Today is July 30th, 2020, so nearly at the end of July. In this video, I wanted to cover a few things about cryptocurrencies and Bitcoin, because this week I've had so many messages and emails and PMs on Facebook and what have you about, number one, crypto fees. I don't know if you've, unless you've been sitting under a rock, Bitcoin fees and Ethereum fees are starting to creep up really, really high. And we've got a lot of members making payments, and the last few days the payments have been going through, like they've been sitting three days on the exchanges and what have you. So I just wanted to cover number one, Bitcoin fees, and number two, exchanging cryptocurrencies, because we've got a lot of people. I've got no Litecoin, I've got no Ethereum. How do I exchange this to that, and so on and so on? So I did a little bit of research, and basically below or above this video, again, depending on where you're going to watch this video, you'll see a link to the fourwaysmarketing.com. Okay, this is our team build page for the Early Birds team build, and we have. It's not just a sales page. It's actually it is a sales page for our team. We've got over here, we've got our projects, ads in ETH, ads in Litecoin, ads in Bitcoin. We've got other projects what we're busy with in the team build. You'll find those on the page. These are some of our other team build projects. Get involved with all of them. We have got a new project to add. At the minute, I've added it to the ads in network. That's a free tool. Join that. Absolutely free to get in, and in the back of that back office there, you'll see a bonus downline builder. And at the very, very bottom, there's a new project just been added. This weekend, I will be adding it to the Early Birds downline and my various links and all of our projects. So keep an eye out for that. But definitely join Adyen Network. Have a look in the back office. Free to join. But anyway, go if you scroll down the page, you'll see. Obviously, you'll see this is my page, Jim Watts. We make these pages for our Early Birds members. Bonus programs is Jim's bonus programs. All the other programs on this page are exactly the same. Okay, some are old, we need to update. If you come across a page where you don't see these projects, just give us a shout with the URL, and I'll find it, because we've made hundreds of these pages. But anyway, going back to crypto. Further down the page, we have a Bitcoin and crypto section. Now, if you just go to that section there, you'll see the current price of Bitcoin. That's powered by CoinDesk. It's a widget we've stuck in there, just so if you're not sure about the Bitcoin price, you can always have a quick look there. But topics about buying crypto. Okay, we've got a lot of people say, where can I buy some crypto? This site I've used in the past. To be honest, I don't buy that much crypto because I earn it. But if you just hover over, give it a click, and you can pop over there and buy some crypto. I'll just quickly click it. You can buy some crypto there. Change Jelly, Change Ellie or Jelly. I'm not sure how you pronounce it, but there you can buy crypto over there from that site. But you will pay a little bit on fees and what have you. But if you're desperate for a place to buy fees, crypto Visa card. That's I use that every day, or 9 days out of 10, should we say. I use it every day. If I do my grocery shopping, or pay my internet or whatever, I use that card. And basically, that card there, you load your crypto on the card, exchange it onto your. I'll just quickly find the card. It's you just literally. I just cover the numbers. Wirex Visa card, with the chip in there, contactless and everything else. It's super. You get no problems with it. So if you want, have a look at that. So it's not available in all countries, but definitely, I think they're expanding globally, and it's a very, very, very. I've never had any problems with it. I know there's a few members in our team use that card. What is Bitcoin? There's three sections for hardware wallets. There's a hardware wallet section there. I will say I've just bought a Nano Ledger. If you click that one, hardware wallet. If you haven't got a hardware wallet, you've got to get one. I'm telling you. But I have a Nano S. I've got a couple of Nano S's actually, but they're quite small. And I was talking to someone last week, and I said, "Oh, try a Nano X." And the Nano X is like literally, it's bigger. Oh, no, I've got my Nano S in the box. I use the Nano S as a backup now, but the Nano X, is Bluetooth. If you want to use it with your phone and what have you, to be honest, I don't. I plug the cable in, but the buttons are, instead of the buttons being before sitting on the top, there was like really fiddly to play with. The buttons on, on the X are on the front. So there's button one, there's button two. So you make, do your confirmations. It's a hell of a lot easier to use. So if you're thinking about a hardware wallet, Nano X, give that a look over. And there's a link on the page, takes you to the Nano website. The Nano S is okay. There's nothing wrong with it. But honestly, if you're going to go for it, I purchased those two, like a backup pack. So I've got a new Nano S and a new Nano X together, $149. $149, the free hunters will start screaming, but that's nothing. That's like literally your bank account. And your private keys is on there. Nobody can get in your wallet. I cannot stress this enough. Okay, if you don't go for the Ledger Nano, go for something, but get a hardware wallet ASAP. These are the ones I have. KeepKey. I use that, for my bits and bobs. But definitely, you've got to get one. There's a desktop wallet there and an online crypto wallet. The hardware is the safest. It's your keys. Nobody can play with your wallet. If you've got your private keys, those 12 words are your private keys, and your private key. And your public key is locked in on that device. TradingView, a lot of people want to see what's going on. You can click that, have a bit of a play. I will get to the bit in a minute, what the topic of this video. TradingView, you can just basically, you can see what's going on. If you, to be honest, I don't trade. A lot of people have tried to get me into Forex and everything else. I don't do it. But I do watch it. I've on the other screen. I'm watching it right now. It's a disease. I like to see the charts going up and down, and I like to even predict what's going to happen. But I never ever trade. It's something I've always believed in. Just hold your coins use it as a currency and that. But I'm not a crypto. I'm not a trader. So all of a sudden, just because crypto comes out, I see all these experts come online, and all of a sudden they're all bloody expert traders. If it was that easy, then why weren't they doing it with dollars before? Just because it's crypto, it doesn't mean that it's any easier. But if you want to have a look, some people like to do it. Now, getting to the subject, crypto exchange. Now, this week, well, again, because Bitcoin's creeping up and the fees are creeping up, a lot of people are saying, well, what's the right fee? Because they're paying ridiculously low fees, and then they're getting blocked on the blockchain because the miners don't want to play with them if they're not paying enough fees. Now, on our four ways page, I'll come to the exchange in a second, but we've got a BTC. You can click there, and I use this regular because when I'm paying something, I honestly don't know what the fee is. What's the standard fee at the minute? If you click the BTC fee checker, it'll open a mempool, and it'll show you. Basically, these are the next five trans, next four blocks. Now, there's a block every 10 minutes. So if you want, say you're making a payment from your wallet, whichever, if it's hardware, desktop, or what have you, and you want it done really, really fast, it's showing you here. Basically, that's roughly, it's not an exact science, but that's roughly the amount of sats you would need to pay to get your transaction in that block. So if you wanted it done super fast, you would pay 192, and in your wallet, you put a custom fee in there. If you, just an example, put in, if you want to make a payment now and you put in, I'm going to pay 20 sats, just an example. If you look there, for that's in the next 10 minutes, that's in the next 20 minutes, so that's in the next two blocks, in the next 30 minutes, that so th those are what you would have to pay, plus or minus, to get a chance of your transaction going through in that particular time frame. If you paid 110, you're looking at the next 68 blocks. So if you paid, example, 20 sats, which some of our members did in the early bids, and then started crying, "Oh, me transaction's blocked," you would be looking on like 144 blocks plus, and there's only one block every 10 minutes. So you do your calculations. So this is a handy tool. This is the next four, and this is basically the last five transactions. So you can see there, these were, 29 minutes ago, 31 minutes ago, 59 minutes ago. It's showing you what the average sat was as far as Bitcoin fees. So if, again, nobody likes to pay huge fees, but it is what it is. And I'll get on to Litecoin in a minute, but that's something else. But it gives you a good idea what's going on. And if you, just an example, if you're shying out on the fees, and you, if you pay right now, just an example, you pay 50 sats on your wallet, on your wallet fees, in your wallet field, there's always somewhere in your wallet where you can place a custom fee or what have you. If you paid 50 right now, you wouldn't get a chance to get that transaction done very quick. Okay, so, and again, those, that tells you the history. So that was 30 minutes ago. How many transactions was in that block? The block number and everything else. How much was filled? But it's pretty accurate. So if this definitely is a good way of making sure that you're paying the right fee, and also you're not paying too much, because sometimes in your wallet, I've noticed, even in Ledger, I've noticed that sometimes it says 100 sats automatically, like as a standard. And when I go to the mempool, if it's on a quiet time of day, it's like 25 sats. So you're paying three times or four times as much. So it's both works both ways. Definitely keep checking the mempool before you make your purchases, and it'll give you a good idea of the current situation. You can see there's 54,000 transactions in the blockchain waiting, hanging around. So it's quite busy right now. And then you see the fees. Sometimes you'll see very low fees waiting, transactions waiting, so the fees are cheaper because there's no competition. But now everybody, if you've got 54,000 and it can only handle, say, 2,700, 2,800 transactions every 10 minutes, the more you pay, the sooner you'll get it done. So a lot of people watching this video know about Bitcoin fees, but a lot won't, so watch out, bear with us. So definitely, go over to the four ways. I would suggest fourwaysmarketing.com. I will put the link below above the video. Bookmark the page and stick it in your bookmarks bar over, in your browser. Stick it in there, and then you can always nip over to it and reference that BTC checker. Now the next one, the next subject, was really the main purpose of this video, was exchanging crypto. There's a lot of places you can exchange crypto. I try not to do it too much. Obviously, I keep Litecoin, I keep Ethereum, I keep a Bitcoin. Not much else, to be honest. I don't play around with much with altcoins. But there's a lot of people asking me this week, because we've got ads in Litecoin, and because the fees are going up, as far as Bitcoin, and Ethereum's definitely going up. Ethereum's getting back, a lot of delays in the transactions, and the fees are creeping up really, quite big still. At the top of our page, we've got ads in Ethereum, ads in Litecoin, ads in Bitcoin. You can fund all of those with Litecoin or Ethereum or Bitcoin. Okay, but ads in, this is just Jim's opinion, ads in Litecoin, or Litecoin, should we say, is I prefer it. It's very, very cheap. I can transfer, and I did it today. I transferred like $30, $40 for 2 cents. 2 cents. When I was doing Bitcoin, it was $2. So in Bitcoin and Litecoin, there's not much difference as far as how to use it. There's no difference. This is really it's the silver of Bitcoin. This is the gold, should we say, and this is the silver, but it's a lot cheaper. The minute the transactions are hugely faster, because obviously the blockchain on Bitcoin is overloaded. And this is just the start. Can you imagine what it's going to be like down the road? And this is why on all of our projects in the past, I've sort of fixed it so we can purchase with Litecoin, Ethereum, and Bitcoin. Okay, but anyway, exchange. Now on the four ways page, I've placed a widget there. Now you can either click, just an example, if you go over here, exchange crypto, just give that a click and it'll take you over to change now. And I use this if I'm changing from one to another. This is one I use. Basically, you'll just put in there what you want to change from. So just an example, if you want to change, like half a Bitcoin, just an example, and you want some Litecoin. Then you've got a drop down menu. You've got the so there you want you're going to send half of Bitcoin and you want to get back Litecoin, and then you click exchange, and then basically this put in there the Litecoin wallet where you want to receive the Litecoin, because this is what you're telling them you're going to send them Bitcoin and you want to get back Litecoin. You put in the Litecoin address where you want them to send you the Litecoin. Click next, and then basically it'll send you on the screen. It'll have a wallet address where to send that Bitcoin. It's a specific wallet address for that transaction, and then just stand by. Literally, as it picks it up, you see here the thing. Confirming the exchange, and then completing the transaction. I've used it for a few years. Never had a pick a bother with it. You can change from any currency that you can see there. All the different currencies, stable coins, and everything else. There's loads you can change from. It's not that, I mean, you will pay fees. This is how the site runs. It's not here for free. It is what it is. This is a business for them. It's a crypto exchange. And then you can change from anything to basically anything you want. But I would strongly suggest if our team, get yourself some Litecoin. Again, I've always loved Litecoin. A lot of people who know me know I preach about Litecoin all the time. Super fast transaction fees, and I have a sneaky suspicion this is going to go nuts. Well, that's just Jim's opinion. The reasoning behind that is, as Bitcoin grows and the transaction fees grow, which they did in back in 2017, what have you. The transaction fees grow. Ethereum is going. The DeFi projects on Ethereum are going nuts. So there's transaction fees are going up. The congestion's going up. Litecoin is, for me personally, it's a no-brainer as far as a payment gateway. It's very cheap, very easy, and I've also put on the website on the Four Ways Marketing page on main on Jim's page. I will be adding these to our members' pages over the weekend. I've put a widget on there, so basically you can either go to the exchange crypto tab over here or just literally go to the exchange, the widget. Just click, just an example, you want to change point. Let's have a look. Let's just do a quick test. So you want 1.2 Bitcoin and you want to get let's have a look, what should I say, Litecoin. That would 0.2 Bitcoin would get us 38.34 Litecoin exchange. And then again here, so you add your Litecoin address, and then also add a refund address. Sometimes, if let's say something goes wrong, I've never had that, to be honest. I don't even use the refund address, but just pop in your wallet address, Bitcoin wallet address, where you want it to go if you need, if there's a problem, if there's a refund. So it would send you back that 2.2 Bitcoin to your refund address if there was a problem. I've never had one, to be honest, but to be honest, I never really use that. But basically the most important is where they want them to send the Litecoin, and it's done literally on the fly. As when you click next, it gives you a Bitcoin wallet address where to send this amount, whatever you're saying, and it's literally you'll see it on the fly. Just sit and watch the screen and it'll get all sorted out pretty quick. But there's a widget there, like I said, or you can go to the website. It's the same. Okay, so I'm going to keep this short. I had to cover the Bitcoin fees because it's a lot of our members are funding the accounts, purchasing, and then sitting waiting literally days because they paid the wrong fee. So the BTC fee checkout is very, very, very handy tool, and the exchange from one crypto to another is pretty cool as well. So I'll catch you in the next video. I'll probably make one over the weekend, but I think those two subjects is pretty was needed, let's be honest. Okay, so have a good one. I'll catch you in the next video.